Okay, now we are doing a cystoscopy to another chronic cystitis patient. For this patient, we did the cystoscopy in office, and we see very interesting things. Look at here, this is the biopsy site. Previously, biopsy is taken from this part, and it came squamous metaplasia, and the doctor said, okay, this is normal, we will not do anything. Then she continued to have infections. And the part that take the biopsy, look, this is a healed, completely healed part. It is now completely healed. But these parts, there is thick leukoplakia tissues there, and these are newly forming leukoplakia. So there's a difference in leukoplakia too. This is a fresh leukoplakia, this is an older leukoplakia. Here there are leukoplakias. Okay, my instrument hit here, you see the mucosa tears. Yeah, when I scrape like this, you see the fresh leukoplakia is going away. Here, look at this one. Look at the floating particle. Yeah, this part is very regenerative. Look here, you can see the tissues. They are scraped easily. And the underneath, there is fresh, good mucosa. This is the old biopsy site. And it heals. So I'm just scraping now. Look at these tissues, I don't know. Okay. Yeah, underneath this is a fresh tissue. This lady has the disease for 11 years, but she didn't use very long-term antibiotics, so I am expecting. Scraped parts are bleeding now. This is the right retrieval device. Yeah, the bladder mucosa is a little more fragile than I expected. Flexible cystoscopy, and we checked the upper parts of the bladder. They were quite normal. I will check again. Okay, upper part, this is 12 o'clock part. It seems normal. These are important to look. This part of the bladder is always, we can miss some tissues, and it's not easy to see with this rigid cystoscope. So previously doing a flexible cystoscope may be a good idea. So this is a part beyond the trigone. When I look at other parts, you see this is really, when I see the leukoplakias initially on this cystoscopy, I was expecting a more healthy bladder, but this bladder, I don't know if it will bleed, it didn't bleed yet. But really, it's too much affected from the disease. Look at some sort of tissue. scraping happens in these parts. Some tissue is coming out. Okay. These are the scraped tissues. They are bleeding underneath. Sometimes, if it is not enough to clean with the just with the fulguration, I also see reduced resection energy. This is a more powerful energy. These parts are bleeding because of the scraping. So now the healthy leukocyte will come here, and as in the biopsy site, the healthy leukocyte is resistant to infections. In the biopsy site, we see, although it's in the middle of the scar tissue, it was not affected. We leave the orifice here. Our extent in the retro part, I will come up to here. Retro seems healthy. There are some other such things. This is sphincter, muscle tissue that's holding here. Can you come? We are now emptying the bladder and observing the dome of the bladder, top of the bladder when we empty. I don't see bleeding parts, it's good, but I'm sure there will be some. I also vacuum clean the bladder with the instrument. Okay, now I will feel again this part incorporated. Orifices are good. For the limits here, maybe I have to do a little more. It's enough. I was about to finish, but my assistant noticed that there are some residual tissues. It's very difficult to not to miss some tissues, and if we miss some tissues, we may return. finishing, I think this will be enough. I will look at the vagina and clean the these particles and build this up.